faithful.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let's just quickly turn our Bibles to the book of Luke. Luke chapter 7. Luke chapter 7. And then, Shekhan, I'm going to need you by the end. I'm just going to do some teaching today, so we'll have to go through a number of scriptures. So we'll have to prepare for me just to do the scriptures. Amen. Luke chapter 7. Luke chapter 7, I'll start reading from verse 36. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says, before we're there, let's just say amen.
Amen.
So Luke chapter 7, from verse 36, the Bible says, and one of the Pharisees asked him to eat with him, and he went to the Pharisee's house and he sat down to eat. And behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner. I want us to note that verse 37. And behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus sat at the table in the Pharisee's house, she brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil and stood at his feet behind him, weeping. She began to wash his feet with tears and wiped them with hair of her head, and she kissed his feet and anointed him. Amen. Then when the Pharisees, verse 39, when the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he spoke to himself saying, this man, if he were a prophet, would know who and what manner of woman this is who is touching him, for she is a sinner. And Jesus answered and said, Simon, I have something to say to you. So he said, teacher, say it. He said, there was a certain creditor who had two debtors, one owed 500 denaro and the other 50. And when they had nothing with which to repay, he freely forgave them both. Tell me, therefore, which of them will love him more? Simon answered and said, I suppose the one whom he forgave more. And he said to him, you have judged rightly. Verse 44. Then he turned to the woman and said to Simon, do you see this woman? I entered your house, you gave me no water for my feet, but she has washed my feet with her tears and wiped them with her hair. You gave me no kiss, but this woman has not ceased to kiss my feet since the time I came in. You did not anoint my head with oil, but this woman has anointed my feet with fragrant oil. Verse 47, therefore I say unto you, her sins which are many are forgiven, for she loved much, but to whom little is forgiven, the same loves little. Then verse 48, then he said to her, your sins are forgiven. And those who sat at the table with him began to say to him, who is this who even forgives sins? Then he said to the woman, your faith has saved you. Amen. Your faith has saved you. So you go in peace. Amen. I want us to note verse 50. It says, your faith has saved you and you go in peace. Amen. Now quickly read verse 17. The same book of Luke, verse 17, verse 5. Luke, verse 17, verse 5. Verse 17, verse 5. Amen.
Amen.
And the Bible says that, and the apostles said to the Lord, increase our faith. I want us to mark that. Increase our faith. Then so the Lord said, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you can say to this mulberry tree, be put up by the roots and be planted in the sea, and it would obey you. Amen. Let us pray.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we just want to give you praise, we give you glory, and we give you all the honor. I just want to thank you for your faithfulness, Jehovah God. I want to thank you for your love for our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. You alone are faithful, you alone are worthy, and you have seen it worthy for us to be here today. Therefore, as we come into your presence to hear your word, I pray that your word shall enlighten us in the mighty name of Jesus, that your word, Jehovah God, shall find room within our lives, that your word, Jehovah God, shall lift us up in the mighty name of Jesus. Therefore, I just pray that each and every one of us shall be blessed because we came as your presence. Father, may you just use me as a vessel, even as I stand into your, in your presence. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. 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 We've just been reading two verses. Amen. Today, I know Mama Chakala some time back, she preached on a message about faith. But today I just want to go through a few things about the results of faith. Because we might say, why do we need faith? Amen. We see this story of the lady in Luke chapter 7 verse 50 who was a prostitute. The Bible says she was a prostitute, she was a sinner. But she went before Jesus Christ and she bought a very expensive oil and she bowed before him, she cried over him, she wiped his feet and she anointed them. The people condemned to say, why is he mixing with these sinners? Amen. But we see here that Jesus overlooked all that she did. Then in the end, when in verse 50, the Bible says that he said to the woman, that your faith has saved you, so you go in peace. Amen. He says, your faith has saved you, you go in peace. I want us to look at the results of faith for us as the believers. Why do we need faith? Amen. When we read in the book of Luke chapter 17 verse 5, the disciples, they said to Jesus, they said, please increase our faith. Why? Because faith produces results in us. Amen.
Amen.
Faith produces results in each and every one of us. Amen. We saw a few definitions of faith. I'll just quickly read through some of them. Because the Bible in Hebrews chapter 11 verse 1, it says that faith is the substance of things that are hoped for. It is the evidence, amen, of those things that are not seen. There's some simpler versions for us to understand which I was looking at. It was saying that having complete trust or confidence in something or in someone, that is what faith is. It is putting your trust into something or to someone else so that they can do what you yourself cannot do. Amen. So that is what faith is. In some other places I read, it's talking about a spiritual conviction within you. And that is what faith is. So today we're looking at the result of faith in the life of the believer. Why do you need faith? Our prayer today should be, Lord, increase our faith. Because we might wonder, why were they saying that, Lord, increase our faith? There's something that faith does to us. Amen. That's why they were asking that, increase our faith. And say to them that if you have faith like a mustard seed, you should speak to this mountain. And that you move and the mountain shall move. Amen. So why do we need faith? I said to them, I'm going to do a lot of teaching, so just bear with me. Those who are right, I'll give you all the scriptures. Because I want us to understand the results of faith. Because when we understand the results of faith, they will say, God, increase our faith. And that's how we'll be able to hold on to faith. Because you cannot hold on to what you do not understand. Whatever you get, it has to produce results. If it doesn't produce results within you, then there's no way, amen, that it is going to work for you. Hallelujah. So what is the necessity of faith? We need faith in order for us to deal with God. Amen. Faith enables us to deal with God. Like I said, having trust or confidence in someone. Like I said, there's a spiritual conviction. God is a spirit. So in order for us to communicate with us, with him, we need faith. Amen. Because we cannot deal with him without faith. Because everything we see is faith. He says it is a substance. Those of us who have learned science, we know what it means, a substance. It's a substance of things of. It says the evidence of those things that are not seen. So in order for us to relate with God, we need what? We need faith. We cannot deal with God minus faith. Hallelujah. In the book of Acts, chapter 16, verse 31. Acts chapter 16. Verse 31, we're looking at the necessity of faith. We need faith in order to deal with God. We need faith in order to enable us to deal with Him, because without it, we cannot deal with God. So why do we need faith? We need faith for our salvation.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because we need to believe. If somebody came to you today and said, Sister Nana, how do you believe in God? Have you seen Him? How do you know that He has forgiven you your sins? How do you know that you are saved? How do you know you have received foundation? Can you show it to me? But it's by faith that you believe that there is a God. It is by faith that we believe. So the necessity for faith is for our salvation. Because we can't be saved minus faith. Amen. The Bible in Acts 16 verse 31, it says, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. That's Acts 16 verse 31. It says, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved. Amen. So you have to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ in order for you to be saved. And that's what Acts 16 verse 31 says. Believe in the Lord. Amen. That believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, Acts 16 verse 31, and you'll be saved. So what is it to believe? So we believe by faith. Amen.
Amen.
Then in Isaiah chapter 45 verse 22. He says, look to me and be saved. Amen.
Amen.
Isaiah 45 22. He says, look to me and be saved, all you, the ends of the earth, for I am God, amen,
amen.
And there is no other.
Amen.
So we need, so the necessity of faith is for our salvation,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Even as we have read in the two scriptures, Acts 16, verse 31, and Isaiah 45, verse 22. So it is for our salvation and the necessity of faith. Because we have to believe on Him to be saved. We have to look to Him to be saved. Amen.
Amen.
He says, because He is God. And there is no other God that is there. Amen.
Amen.
But I just want to bring to attention, because it is a spiritual conviction that is within us. There are two types of faith I want to introduce. First of all, there's the head kind of faith. The nature of faith. Like where the physical knowledge of God, where everybody knows that there is God. You can ask anyone in the street, they'll tell you that yes, there is a God. Even those who are not Christians, amen, they know that there is a God. So that is the head belief of God. But today I want us to move to the heart belief. Amen. There is a heart belief of God. Amen. That is the faith that comes from the heart. The faith that comes from a spiritual conviction. The faith that comes from accepting Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Not just to know, but to believe.
Amen.
To know that He is.
Amen.
To know that He is. To know that He is the deliverer.
Amen.
To know that He is the healer. To know that He is the provider. To know that He is the sustainer.
Amen.
That is the kind of faith that needs to dwell in us.
Amen.
That's why when the disciples said, increase our faith. They had the head knowledge. They knew He was the Christ. But they wanted more than that. To know Him as Christ. To know Him as the resurrection. Because we can see this when God was, when Jesus Christ was asking them to say, they came to Him and said, some are saying you are John the Baptist. Some are saying that you are Apollos. Some are saying that you are so and so. But then He asked them as individuals, but you, take to your neighbor, just ask them, but you, who do you say I am?
Jesus.
He says, who do you say I am? And it's only Simon Peter who answered and said, you are the truth. You are the resurrection. You are the Christ. And then He said to him that, you know what? Flesh and blood has not revealed this unto you. It's only the Spirit of God.
Amen.
So that is the type of faith that we need. The heart kind of faith that knows Him as Jesus Christ. Knows Him as the Christ. We have that banner on here that we, which we confess our confession. That Jesus Christ is the only Son of the living God. That is the heart belief, amen,
amen,
that we need to have as Christians, hallelujah.
Amen.
Now we've talked about that. Now we're going to the object of faith. I just wanted to mention two things on the object of faith. So where do we derive this faith from? So the object of faith, it comes from the word of God. Because the Bible in Romans 10 verse 17, it says that faith comes by hearing. And by hearing what? By hearing the word of God. Not by hearing the word of man. Not by hearing the word of the prime minister. Not by hearing the word of, I don't know, it's another sangoma as we have. We hear the word. Not the word of the wisdom. Not the word. But it says that faith comes by hearing. And only by hearing the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody had an analogy about fear. And they said that fear was false evidence which appeared real. But it says faith comes by hearing. And by hearing the word of God. And secondly, the second object of faith is the person of the Lord Jesus Christ himself. Amen.
Amen.
Because he says that believe in me. We just believed it. He says believe in me, the Christ. He says look to me, the Christ. Not in vain things, but to me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that is the object of our faith. And now because we have the word. Amen. We know the word is the Lord Jesus Christ. So now we're just going to quickly look at the results of faith. We see this woman in Luke chapter 7, which we're just reading, verse 50. This woman, the Bible says she was a sinner, and she went into the presence of Jesus. Then everybody says, why is he accepting this sinner? But then we see that at the end of it all, when she left, she was redeemed. She left as a person who was forgiven. But what caused her to be forgiven? He told her that it is your faith. He says your faith has saved you.
Amen.
So therefore you go in peace. So your faith matters. Amen.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor that your faith matters.
Your faith.
That's why we need to tell God that increase our faith. Manifesting through your life. So I want us to look at the results of faith in the life of the believer. Because you might say, why should I increase my faith? No, you need to, so that you can see results. There are results in having faith in God.
Amen. Amen.
There are results in having faith in God. So unless you see those results in having faith in God, then you will not have faith. That's why they could not see what Jesus Christ was talking about. That's why they said to the end that, you know what? Increase our faith so that we can see what you see.
Amen.
It says the evidence of things that are not seen, things that are hoped for, so that we can see those things that you see. Because wherever they went, he performed miracles. He saw hope. He saw life. So that we can see those things that you see. He said what? Increase our faith. Amen.
Amen.
Can somebody open for me in the book of Romans chapter 4? Just put your hand on Romans chapter 4. If someone can open for me Romans chapter 4, put your finger there. You'll be reading it for us. And I'm just going to read the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 15. So we look at the results of faith in the believer. So the first result of faith in the believer is that it makes us righteous. Amen.
Amen.
Genesis chapter 15 verse 6. The Bible says that, and he believed in the Lord. Genesis 15 verse 6. It says, and he believed in the Lord, and it was accounted to him for righteousness. It is talking about Abraham.